Located in the heart of Ypsilanti, Michigan, at the intersection of Huron and Cross Street is one of Michigan's lesser-known interpretive centers. Designated as a part of Motor City's National Heritage Area, the Michigan Firehouse Museum is housed in a restored firehouse that also encompasses a new 10,000-square-foot addition. It was founded in 1998 with a mission to preserve and interpret Michigan's firefighting history, as well as teach and promote fire safety and prevention. Actively collecting firefighting equipment and archival materials locally and nationally, the Michigan Firehouse Museum offers visitors an opportunity to see and learn about firefighters in Michigan and nationwide.
What people can gain from visiting this museum is a good sense of history about how difficult firefighting can be. It can be a very dangerous job, but it's also a very necessary job. Today's role of firefighters is extended quite a bit more than what it used to be. There are not as many major fires, but they also go to accidents and things like that. But what I think people can get from visiting the museum is a sense of how dedicated these people were, how innovative these people were, just a general appreciation for the fact that somebody is in service to them and looking out for them or is there when they need help. I think that's what you gain from this museum. And we try to showcase those things, not only through the vehicles and the apparatus, but by describing the history of it. And people usually come away with a good sense and appreciation for what they've seen.
Built in 1898 in the then-popular Romanesque Revival architectural style, the firehouse actively served the city until 1975. The restoration offers visitors a glimpse into the 1900s era firehouse life, complete with horse-drawn vehicles and the bunk-style living accommodations on the second floor, equipped with the original fireman's or sliding pole, a polished brass metal pole installed between floors and fire stations that were first invented in the 1870s.
Fire pole is there because they can quickly get from where their living quarters down to the fire rigs and get off and onto the fire as quickly as possible.
The new 10,000-square-foot addition has an extensive collection of fire apparatus of all kinds, hand, horse, and engine-propelled. Displays include the evolution of fire extinguishers and alarms, helmets, ladders, breathing gear, clothing, fire truck bells, and hose nozzles. An extensive collection of vintage model fire trucks, along with other firehouse-related memorabilia, and some items that date back to 1492. The museum staff and volunteers are actively involved in the community.
The Michigan Firehouse Museum has several events that we hold, starting in, now our new event starting in March, which is the Comedy Jam, and that's going to be an annual event because it was such a success this year that we're going to keep it as an annual event. Then we have our golf outing, which is one of our fundraising events, and that money goes towards our junior fire marshal camp, which is in October, and that is held during Fire Prevention Week.
This unique facility also hosts its own fire truck muster, a gathering of antique fire truck enthusiasts and their beautiful machines from across the country. The Michigan Firehouse Museum showcases a historical cross-section of fire emergency warning bell systems. This collection includes hand-rung bells that were used before sirens were invented, as well as foot-operated bells that visitors can try for themselves. All offer visitors a way to ring up historical experiences from the turn of the century. Of interest to many visitors is the evolution of firefighting uniforms. A red uniform would commonly be seen on rural community volunteers where full-time professionals were few and far between. An ornate blue uniform worn only by officers who earned rank and gained distinction for their community protection is indicative of the esteem in which firefighters were held by their communities. The museum also contains a display of rare self-contained breathing apparatus, or SCBAs. The collection also includes compressed air tanks, like those used by divers, adapted to give firemen reserves of fresh air when rescue missions took them into dangerous, smoke and fume-filled spaces. Early tanks were heavy and bulky and had capacities that were generally rated for somewhere between 10 and 15 minutes. And the duration of fresh air supply depended largely on how hard the firemen were breathing as they carried out their rescues. Many of the fire trucks also carried resuscitators in support of the crews that had to carry out the building's search and rescues. Typically, the smaller trucks also carried medical supplies to the curbside of the sites. Rare firehouse logos and the embroidered shoulder uniform patches from various departments and different stations are on display. This collection is growing as more visitors from the firefighting brotherhood nationwide come to visit and send in new items. These contributions, whether historical or modern, are still in use and are always welcome. Unusual even for a unique museum such as this is the display of life nets. The life nets were used to catch people who jumped from the upper floors of burning buildings. It wasn't until the advent of the high-tech ladder trucks of today, capable of reaching the tallest high-rise for city rescues, that these clever inventions were retired. Even though times and techniques have changed dramatically over the years, as you walk through the museum, you can see how firefighting has evolved. The exhibit path progresses, showing visitors hollowed-out logs that were used as water conduits well before hoses came along. And on display are early hand-pump hose carts. In the early days, there were no pressurized water lines or fire hydrants where the fire crews could attach a hose to extinguish a fire. So firefighters would pull hand-powered pump carts to the site to pressurize a water stream to douse a fire. Visitors see why steam engines were eventually adopted and used to pump water for controlling fires. These carts relied less on manpower and more on horses and steam. The development of steam power made it easier on the firefighters to focus more on saving lives. Even though this advance was impressive, it also posed problems such as keeping the steam fire stoked and the serious threat of exploding boiler tanks. The next giant step in the evolution of firefighting apparatuses was the internal combustion engine that powered pump trucks. The first models could not drive and pump at the same time, but it wasn't long before that firefighting innovation provided a better solution. Some believe this development was due to the need of combating quickly spreading brush fires as the population forged its way westward. Don't wait another day to take a stroll through the Firehouse Museum in Ypsilanti, where you are sure to stir childhood dreams of brave men in red and chrome trucks speeding down the street with sirens screaming. These are the men who wrote history in the fascinating evolution of firefighting. Gain a new appreciation of how the valiant men and women in the fire service went about their courageous work to protect and serve. See the authentic gear they wore and the equipment they used. Take a step inside the door of the Michigan Firehouse Museum and take a journey back in time to a place where firefighting techniques and rescues first began. Remember when you wanted to be a fireman?